Okay, so welcome to my next video tutorial on OpenCV, and in this video we'll be going through how to apply a canny image detector, canny edge detector on any image that the user inputs. So let's start by creating our source files in nano main 8.cpp, and we will include the basic header files, so include opencv2/opencv.hpp, and then in using namespace cv, and then declare a function main. Now main will take two arguments, argc and char argv. Now the next task is to take input of the image. So let's just describe our met type imgbgr, because OpenCV reads blue green red and not red green blue, and then img gray. So next task is to read the image, so im read, and we want this to store an imgbgr, so img bgr is equal to im read, and argv1, okay, and sorry, there's a mistake here, imgbgr, and then next what we do is we just apply canny to this img, right? So what we can do is we can declare only one mat type here, one mat object here, or another thing we can do is we can just apply canny on one image and store it to the other mat type. So that's what we are doing here. So let's just apply canny, sorry, the C will be capital here, so canny, so the image on we want to apply, so bgr, and image or the mat type on in which we want to store this, so img and gry, and the next is the two thresholds, so I will use 10 and 100 here, and the next is the ratio we want to use, so make sure to keep the ratio between 3 and 7. The larger the ratio, the more edges will be detected, and the lesser the ratio, the less number of edges will be detected, and the edges will be quite fine here. Next is that you want to apply the L2 gradient or not, so in this case I will use true here. You can also set that to false. If you are using normal images, then there will be no such huge differences, and we have applied a canny to our image, and next we want to show this, so im show, and let's just declare im show once more, use im show once more, sorry, I am not declaring im show, they are already declared in OpenCV libraries. So what we want to show is, let's just this win one, and imgbgr, oops, sorry, so this will be underscore not bracket, imgbgr, and next is win2, and img gry, okay, and next we wait for the wait key, so wait key, and this here, and let's just return 0, and our program ends here. So let's just save this, so control O, control X, and let's just try compiling this here. So main8.cpp. Now I would like to copy one image from this, so the name must be LENA, I think, yes, Control C, and we'll copy the JPEG. Control C, and let's just paste this to our directory. So in OpenCV8, and yep. So next what we'll do is output and lina.jpg, and let's just try. Yep, you see they just deleted, and the lower ratio you keep, and that's it is. Now make sure you do some experiment with the thresholds, the 10 and 100 we gave it here. So make sure to do some experiments, or then only you can understand what those thresholds actually mean. And if you apply the maximum threshold is very maximum, say 10,000, and the minimum is 0, then your image will be completely black. So that's it for today. If you like the video, just give it a thumbs up and do subscribe to my channel, and also support me on Patreon as patreon.com/brightprogrammer. And that's it.